All right. Good afternoon, class. My name's Akajo Ondumba Emmanuel from the Department of Business Administration. We are on study session two, sources of funding entrepreneurship business by Center for Distance Learning and Continuing Education. The course is GSE 301B and BOS 324 for business students. Learning outcomes. When they have studied this study session, you should be able to define entrepreneurship finance, outline the sources of funds available for an entrepreneur, discuss entrepreneurial finance planning, identify bodies established by government to provide entrepreneurship funds. Sources of business finance. Acquisition and allocation of funds is central to success, to the success of any business venture. One of the main problems facing effective management of small-scale enterprises is lack of basic financial management skills needed to guide the business venture. These skills include the ability to keep appropriate records of financial transactions, financial control, credit management, risk management, personal financial discipline of the entrepreneur, and the inability to see the business as separate from owners. United States Small Scale Business Administration suggested the need for entrepreneur to answer the following questions so as to realistically determine the volume of capital needed for its operations. One, why do I need the capital? Two, how much do I need? Three, when do I need it? Four, for how long will I need it? Five, where can I obtain it? Six, how can I pay it back? By the time you provide answers to these questions, you know that you are ready to start business. Now, sources of funds for venture operations. Money is needed to operate and grow or expand a business. May need money to purchase equipment, inventory, creation, awareness, restructure, or even renovate to be properly positioned to handle challenges. There are different forms of raising funds. Raising money for a business is one aspect of financing. There are different forms of raising funds to the entrepreneur. These sources vary in terms of volume of funds that can be accessed, the cost of the funds, and the security required to obtain the funds. Sources of funds for venture operations. We have knowledge, knowing the number of sources of funds available, the risk involved, the duration of financing, where it is short-term or long-term, the cost of borrowing from each source. Five, government restrictions and institutional constraints. Six, the value and nature of assets as security or collateral. Sources of funds continue. The various sources of funds for business venture are classified under the following. The personal and family sources. Two, the internal sources. Three, the external sources. Personal savings. It is expected that an individual will save money personally to start a business. Then loans from friends and associates. That is money you can get from friends, free with donations and what have you, to put into business. Then we have internal sources of funds. We have retained profit. It is an accepted practice. You can retain what you have in your business. Then provisions, provision for tax, the depreciation. All these monies can still be channeled into business again. Reducing current assets. You know, those costs should also be channeled, can also be channeled. Then we have external sources of funds. We have short-term finance, we have medium-term finance, and we have long-term finance. A short-term finance involves obtaining debts that are that have maturity date of less than 1 year. The typical example of short finance include goods purchase on credit, outstanding short-term loans from banks, accrued payment such as deferred taxation, salaries and wages. Medium-term source are the sources where funds are required for a period of more than 1 year, but less than 5 years. The sources of the medium term include borrowing from commercial banks, public deposits, lease financing, and loan from financial institutions. Long-term finance, as the name suggests, this type of finance requires that the funds will be at the disposal of the business venture for a very long time. Now, why do entrepreneurs require loan facility? Normal operations, number two, expansion purpose, and then number three, financial difficulties. To make normal operations, they need loans, and they need loans also to expand their businesses. And then in terms of financial difficulties, government initiative programs targeted to promoting entrepreneurial access to funds. One, National Directorate for Employment was established in the year 1986 with the following functions: National Youth Empowerment and Vocational Skills Development, Agricultural Sector Employment Programs. We have special levy agricultural schemes. We have special public work programs, and we have small-scale industry and graduate employment. Those are the reasons why it was established, the functions it was asked to take place. Now, two, National Poverty Eradication Program, NEPAP, established in year 2001 and charged with the following functions: Youth Empowerment Scheme, Rural Infrastructure Development Scheme, Social Welfare Scheme, a National Resource Development and Conservation Scheme. These are the various schemes that government brought out where monies can be dashed out or dished out in forms of loans and what have you to entrepreneurs. Then, three, Nigerian Agriculture Cooperative and Rural Development Banks, a Family Economic Advancement Program that was later changed to Nigerian Agricultural Development and Rural Development Banks. Two, financial agricultural programs at both micro and macro levels, helping farmers in rural areas by meeting their needs of funds and fertilizer, helping women cooperatives and organizations. We have others like Small and Medium Enterprise Equity Investment Scheme, two, the Microcredit Funds, three, Bank of Industry, for Nigerian Export Import Banks, that is NEXIM. We have commercial banks and merchant banks credit to small scale enterprises. Thank you. Good afternoon, class. This is GST 301B and POS 324, Entrepreneurship Skills, Entrepreneurship Studies 2. My name is Kajon Baimanuel from the Department of Business Administration, Distance Learning, University of Abuja. Our topic today in this session, this section 2-3, is business plan. Our learning outcomes is, when at the end of this session, students should be able to define business plan, they should be able to outline the components of a business plan, and they should be able to identify the definite time when business plan can be done. They can independently prepare a business plan. Now, what is a business plan? This study session introduces you to how to write a business plan. Business plan is likely the life plan for an individual. before you begin writing your business plan, you need to identify how, where, and to whom you intend to sell or produce or provide a service. You also need to assess your competitive environment and understand how much money you need to start your business and to keep it running until it is established. Feasibility studies will be required before a business plan. It gives a better understanding of the entire business, how it's going to look like. Yeah, discussions on business plan. The term business plan has different meanings to different people. Banks that relate them, their own planning guidelines, consider formal business loan applications to be synonymous with business plan. Venture capitalists see them as investment proposals, purely fund-raising documents. Corporate managers think of them in terms of departmental budget and financial forecast. It's touched in 2005. According to Kuratko and Hoggart, 1998, the business plan describes to investor and financial resources all the events that are likely to affect the proposed venture. Details are required for various projected activities of the venture with associate revenue and cost outlines. A business plan describes a business opportunity. It is likely a roadmap because it tells you what to expect and what alternative routes you can take to arrive at your destination. Planning helps you to work smartly rather than harder. It keeps you future-oriented and motivates you to achieve the results of want. Perhaps most importantly, the process of completing a business plan enables you to determine what commitment you need to make to the venture. That is Department of Trade and Economic Development, 2010. Importance of business plan. When you think about what a business plan is to your mind, probably go right to the bank and process for applying for business financing, as that is, it is important when you are planning for your business, important when you want to start a business, because it gives you a guide and it propels you towards the right path, the right approach to use in your business. It is seen as a micro survey that is conducted before business is started. The importance, according to Kagan, 2006, include you plan to launch a new business. Your business has grown substantially. 3, you want to expand your existing business into new markets. 4, you want to add a new product or product line. 5, you are thinking about buying a new business or buying a business. Importance continue, according to Department of Trade and Economic Development 2010. They itemize the following. Control future risk. Also, is also an importance of business plan. Prepare for future uncertainty. 3, control business environment. 4, control business growth. 5, avoid sales crisis. 6, avoid liquidity crisis. Importance of the plan. Avoid succession crisis. Ensure people development. Ensure workspace available. Avoid stock buying crisis. According to Timon and Spinelli, 2004, developing a business plan is one of the best way to define the blueprint, strategic resource, and individual requirements for a new venture. A good business plan must be developed with a view to exploiting the defining opportunities, developing opportunities and determining the sources required, obtaining those resources and successfully managing the resulting venture. Here's Rich, Peter and Schaeffer, 2008. Principles of planning a business plan. They are template for a good business plan. Starts with 1. Explicit. You have to be explicit in all the steps you are going to take. Intelligible. That is capable of being understood by those who carry out the business with you. Flexibility. That is capable of accepting change. Written. Committed to writing in a clear and concise manner. A written business plan should contain the following. 1. Business idea. There's an outline and description of the product or service and background on the industry. 2. The entrepreneur. That is a history of the founder of the business, including the skills, abilities, and proposed ownership structure. 3. Business objective. What the business intends to achieve, including long-range goals, the advantage of the product or service over existing competitors, the image and character of the business to be developed, the produce, the product and services to be offered. Now, components of writing a good business plan. 4. Technical description of the business. That is, under manufacturing, we have description of process and machinery used, patent and design registration. 3. Prediction or change to the industry. 4. Cost of material, machinery. 5. Plant location and layout. The fifth point is labor availability and cost. That is, we have to deal with retailing, that is, goods to be sold, the location, the stocking policy and procedure and suppliers and potential suppliers and the sales team. 7. Service. Description of service, qualification necessary to enter the industry. 8. Industry or legal control. 9. Processes and services to be offered. 10. Financial information. As capital needs, fixed assets needed, working capital needed, and starting capital that is needed. All that has to be taken in cognizance. Sources of finance. We have types of finding of finance needed. And owner's funds to be used. 12, cost of finance. Setup cost, current interest rates, ability to meet borrowing and current returns on owner's funds. 13, financial availability, projected profit and loss account, break-even analysis, projected balance sheet, cash flow forecasts, working capital needed, and then the budget. Expenses, structures, that is 14, expenses, structures, stroke income and taxation. That is, after that, we have what is called the market. Now, market research, market size, market description, market trends, customer profiles, and target market, then preliminary sales forecasts and established market share. Now, competitive position, competitors, unique selling position, quality of existing products and services, and marketing practices of competitors. Now, marketing programs. We have distribution channels, that sales outlets, storage and transport of goods and services, pricing policy, packaging policy, sales promotion and sales strategy, advertising strategy and costs. public relations, management, and operations. We also look at the principles of planning or continuous. Now, personnel, the number of staff needed, skills needed, training programs, and business organization. Former forms of legal organization that says sole trader, partnership, company or trust, registration of business name, organization chart. Now, legal considerations. Look at the license, the federal and state taxes, consumer laws, business laws, and insurance that will cover the business in case of any accident. Look at premises, the space required for the business, buy or rent contracts, buy or rent or contract it, you know, commercial lease or requirements and problems available of suitable programs. Yeah, just questions to be answered in a business plan. Description of the business. We have, what type of business are you planning? Is it retail, wholesale, or manufacturing, or tourism, or hospitality services? Number two, what product or services will you sell? Number three, what type of business is it? Is it new? Is it part-time? Is it expansion? Is it seasonal? And number five, why does it promise to be successful? Questions to be answered in a business plan. Continuous. Under marketing, we have, who are your potential customers? Two, how will you attract and hold your share of the market? Three, who are your competitors? How are their business prospering? How will you promote sales? Who will be your best supplier and why? Where will the business be located? What factors will influence your choice of location? Then what feature will your location have? How will your building contribute to your marketing strategy? What will your building layout feature? Further questions to ask under organization. Who will manage the business? What questions will you look for in a manager? How many employees will you need, and what are their job descriptions? What are your plans for employees, hiring, salary and wages, benefits, training and supervision? How will you manage finances? How will you manage record keeping? What consultants or specialists will you need? What legal form of ownership will you choose? What license and permit will you need? Then, what regulations will affect your business? In this study session, we focus on business plan. We started by defining two concepts. We also looked at their importance and usefulness. Lastly, we highlighted the principles of planning a business plan. Thank you.